Hello, good afternoon to everybody. I'm glad to be here to present my work entitled Efficiency Improvement of Photovoltaic Cells by Coating the Protection Glass with a silica matrix co-doped with erbium and ytterbium lanthanide ions. My name is Henrique José da Silva. I am a professor and a researcher also. And my advisor for this work is Dr. Eduardo José Nassar. I like, first of all, to present all the colleagues that helped me to develop this work. Jessica Batista is a master's student, Dr. Lucas Rocha, and Dr. Eduardo Nassar, my advisor, as I told you. We are from University of Franca, in the city of Franca, in Brazil. There you can see my email. And a picture of our university campus, and also the symbol of our Solgel group. The motivation of this work is simple. First of all, we know that the average solar radiation in Brazil is above 2,500 hours a year, is a lot of sun. So Brazil is propitious for implantation of solar photovoltaic energy systems. Brazil's energy consumption will increase by 41% till 2035. But we have problems with the photovoltaic cells, mainly the low efficiency of those cells. This low efficiency is due to different factors, like incomplete use of all solar radiation, mainly ultraviolet and infrared radiation. Infrared contributes, with almost 50% of the energy coming from the sun. But the photovoltaic cells are not really sensitive to infrared. Materials used to construct the cells are mainly silicon because it's very abundant on Earth. So it means not very expensive. Of course, we know that are other solar cells that use different materials and different constructions, but the efficiency is always very low. And the third reason why the efficiency of photovoltaic cells is low is the high temperatures decrease photovoltaic cells efficiency. Infrared is responsible for the cell's temperature, and the photovoltaic cells exposed to the sunlight reach easily 60 or 70 degrees when exposed directly to the sunlight. So we must solve these problems, and our contribution is related to the attempt of solve these problems, and so to improve the efficiency of the cells. The main goals is so improve the electrical power efficiency of silicon photovoltaic cells. For that, it will be used a matrix of dioxide silicon thin film co-doped with erbium and ytterbium lanthanide ions. The matrix of silicon is obtained by the social process. The use of erbium and ytterbium lanthanide ions is to promote an up conversion process. Up conversion will happen from infrared to visible light, mainly red and green lights. And we know if up conversion occurs, photovoltaic cells will be used the infrared radiation, improving the efficiency. We also know that if the up conversion occurs, the temperature will decrease, improving once more the efficiency. In previous work, we call it the part one of the work, is a laboratory work. We prepared the matrix, the silicon matrix, using the Sol-Gel process. Co-doping this matrix of silicon with the two lanthanides, erbium and ytterbium. We use high temperatures to promote calcination process, and with that remove OH groups, analysis and measurements made to the up conversion process were done, and we used a laser of 980 nanometers to study the conversion from infrared to visible light, and we also construct a matrix of infrared LEDs to study and to obtain the results for electrical characteristics. Measurements of electrical power improvement using the matrix of infrared LEDs have been made. Small silicon polycrystalline photovoltaic cells were used. Study the effect of the use of use different layers of the dioxide of silicon thin film and made. Also the effect of different calcination temperatures were studied. The deep coating process were used to the thin film deposition. And analyses and measurements will show that up conversion is present, and also measurements of voltage, current, and electrical power were made. And so, first we prepared the thin film to get the silicon film. We used the Sol-Gel process. It was used 30 milliliters of a solution containing 20% of TEOS, 20% of water, and 60% of ethanol. This percentage guarantees a good miscibility of the TEOS and the water, and we also used different molar percentages of ytterbium and erbium, maintaining a relation between ytterbium and erbium of 4 to 1. In this work, or part 2, we made experiments in real environment conditions, exposed to photovoltaic cells directly to the sunlight. Commercial cells are used with now standard square dimensions near of 40 centimeters. Also, these cells are of polycrystalline silicon like the small ones. The co-doped dioxide silicon thin film is now used to cover the glass. Is the same glass that protects the photovoltaic cell panels, and this was done because the cells have layers that can be removed, and it is easier to coat the glass instead of the cells because the cells are very fragile. We know the commercial cells have some protection layers, and as the layer of the conducting lines for the current, and have under the T-reflection layer, we know it is not easy to remove that layers, and so we prefer to cover the glass instead of the cell. It was used the same zip coating process, it was used the same calcination temperatures, and measurements of voltage, current, and electrical power were made in this part of the world. Here we have some results of emissions in the part one, where we have the cells covered with the thin film. We used two layers of the thin film, and we used a laser of 980 nanometers. And as can be seen, as you can see in this graphs, we have emission in the green region around 520 and 550 nanometers. In the first and second graph, we maintain the power of the laser and we change the temperature of calcination. And the result shows that till 30 degrees, we have a very nice improvement on the intensity of the emission, and at 400 degrees in the crisis. When we, in the second graph, where we increase the percentage of erbium and deuterium, we saw that the intensity is not so high. The third and the fourth graphs will maintain the temperature of calcination, 300 degrees, and we change the power of the laser. And as expected, when the power of the laser increases, the emission also increases, showing the very big peak, emission peak at the green region, and small, very small in the red region. We'll talk about this using the laser. So these are the results for part one. Then using the laser at 980 nanometers, two green emission band appears. 980 nanometers is the wavelength for excitation of ytterbium. Green emission results for the excitation of two photons in ytterbium. A very low intensity red emission also appears. So in this case, we have with these percentages, we have a better result in the green. In part one, and for the results of electrical characteristics, we construct a matrix of 5x5 infrared LEDs, and also a small black box where we can see the top, the infrared LED matrix, and in the bottom is the photovoltaic cell. The cell is here a polycrystalline, a silicon polycrystalline one, with dimensions of 1 inch by 2 inches. The constructed black box with the matrix of infrared LEDs and the photovoltaic cells are used to obtain the electrical results. So those results of part one are some electrical results. showed an improvement of efficiency, as we can see in this small table. We have for a percentage of erbium and ytterbium of 0.12% and 0.03% of ytterbium, of erbium, we have here 6.04% of improvement on efficiency. Results, these results are for when the cell is covered and not covered with thin film. Differences between the two cells is because they are not expensive commercial cells with a little bit different dimensions, and the irradiated light is only for 980 nanometers wavelength of the infrared. In the second part of the work, we use a commercial silicon polycrystalline photovoltaic cell with dimensions, a square dimension of 14 centimeters, and this cell was covered with the protected glass with the thin film of the silicon coated thin film. The current was measured once again using small resistors. And here we have some results. These results are for different moments. So this graphic shows mean values and for 1 to 7 different situations. The first situation we just have the photovoltaic cell. In the second, the photovoltaic cell is covered with a clean glass and without film, a thin film. And for the third to the seventh situations, we have the photovoltaic cell with the glass, with the thin film, for different temperatures, calcination temperatures, and different percentages. We have improvement of efficiency reaching around 6.7%. 300 degrees seems to be just a little bit better than 200 degrees temperature of calcination, and increasing the percentage of erbium and ytterbium is not seems to be very important. Some conclusions and thinking in the future. From the first part of this study till the end of the second part, some important conclusions can be noted. First, it is absolutely possible to improve the efficiency of the silicon polycrystalline photovoltaic cells. An upconversion process of wavelength can be used, and the cost of this process is not very high. The coverage of the cells or the coverage of the protective glass with erbium and ytterbium, coated silicon thin film, is a valuable solution. One important remark is the industrial process to do this. It could be interesting to integrate the erbium and ytterbium lanthanide ions directly in the cell during the manufacturing process of the cell, or perhaps it could be possible to integrate lanthanides in the protected glass, or perhaps it could be possible to enclosure the thin film between two glasses. Experiments of how long the thin film will be stable, or how is adherence to the cell or to the glass is really effective must be realized. This research showed the improvement of photovoltaic cell efficiency by using the upconversion process promoted by the erbium and ytterbium lanthanides. Other lanthanide ions must be used to get the upconversion for other infrared wavelengths, and so some important questions must be answered and the work must be realized. Some acknowledgments of the Brazilian institutions that helps the group to develop this research, and acknowledgement also for our university and our group of Mogel, and a special thanks to the ICMSCN conference for the opportunity, and kind regards for everyone.